Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. I begin in the name of Allah, the All Beneficent, the All Merciful. Tehzeeb ul Islam by Allama Muhammad Baqir Majlisi, Part 9. Smelling and application of scent, flowers and oil. First, benefits of sweet scent and its proper application. According to reliable traditions, applying scent and smelling it is included in the elegant manners of the prophets. It is stated from Imam Ja'far as-Sadiq, peace be upon him, that sweet scents increase the strength of heart and virility. According to a reliable tradition from Imam Ali Radha, peace be upon him, it is not advisable for man to leave off applying scent. It is better if one applies it every day. If he cannot, he should apply every alternate day. And even if that is not possible, he should never miss applying scent on a Friday. According to Imam Ali, peace be upon him, one should apply scent on the mustaches as it was the habit of the prophets. The angels who record the deed are impressed as they like good scent. According to Imam Ja'far as-Sadiq, peace be upon him, the person who applies it, that is the scent without spirit, in the morning will be free from freak of reason until night. And that the prayer of a person who applies it during prayers is better than 70 prayers performed without it. Another tradition states that people used to recognize the place where Imam Ja'far as-Sadiq, peace be upon him, had done sajda, that is bowing down during prayers, by the scent which used to emanate from the place. According to a tradition from the Holy Prophet, the scent which is used by women should have a prominent color and its perfume subdued, whereas the scent used by men must possess a subdued color and impressive perfume. Imam Ali, peace be upon him, states that it is imperative for a woman to be always well perfumed for the sake of her husband. Second, aversion on refusing scent or perfume. People asked Imam Ja'far as-Sadiq, peace be upon him, whether it was proper for a person to refuse perfume when it is offered. The Imam replied that it is not advisable to refuse the creation of Almighty. According to a tradition, people brought perfumed oil as a gift to Imam Ali, peace be upon him. He accepted the gift and applied it to his body, though he had already applied oil to his body earlier in the day, and said that he had never refused perfume at any time. Another tradition states that the Holy Prophet never used to refuse the sweets and perfumes brought for him. According to Hasan ibn Juwayn, he visited Imam Ali Radha, peace be upon him, one day. The Imam brought a container which had musk in it and asked him to take some from it. He did what was told. He ordered to take musk once more and apply it on his neck and garment. He did what he was told and there was a little left in the container. The Imam asked him to take that much also and apply it as he had applied before, and said that except a donkey, no one refuses the wonders of God. When Hasan inquired of the Imam as to what were the wonders of the Almighty, the Imam replied, perfume, relaxing cushions which people offer one to sit comfortably, and also those things which are the signs of respect. Third, the blessings of musk, umber and saffron. According to Imam Ja'far as-Sadiq, peace be upon him, perfume implies musk, saffron and oud. Another tradition states that Imam Ali Zain al-Abidin, peace be upon him, possessed a musk container made of alloy, that is rang. Before changing his clothes, he used to apply a little on his body. Another tradition states that he kept a little bottle of musk in his prayer mat and used to apply it every time he stood for prayers. Another tradition states that the Holy Prophet used to apply so much musk that the color of the musk could be seen on his forehead. Another tradition states that Imam Ali Radha, peace be upon him, possessed a bottle of scent which had many sections in it. Each section contained a separate perfume, and in one section there was musk. Another tradition states that Ali, the son of Imam Ja'far as-Sadiq, asked his elder brother Imam Musa Kazim, peace be upon him, whether it was permissible to mix musk in the oil which was applied on the body. The Imam said that it was not harmful as he himself mixed musk with the oil meant for body. Many traditions have praised khuluq, which is name of a perfume, but some traditions have prohibited its constant use. Fourth, advantages of ghaliya, that is musk. According to reliable tradition, it is stated that Ishaq ibn Ammar said to Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq, peace be upon him, that when he meets merchants, he applies a little ghaliya, that is musk, that they may not think him poor. The Imam said that whether the ghaliya is more or less, it does not matter, and even a little of its application once in a while is enough. Ishaq said that he listened to the advice of Imam, and only with ghaliya worth 10 dirhams, he was able to keep himself perfumed for the whole year. 5th. Advantages of almond and banafsha oil. According to a reliable tradition from Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq, peace be upon him, the greatness of banafsha oil over others is comparable to the greatness of Ahlul Bayt over other people. One should rub it in good quantity as it cures all sorts of headaches and eye troubles. According to a tradition from Aqba, a person fell down from a donkey. The Imam ordered that drops of almond and banafsha oil should be poured into the injured man's nose. The man felt greatly relieved. Then the Imam addressed Aqba thus, O Aqba, banafsha oil gives heat in winter and is cool in summer. It is beneficial for our Shias and harmful for the unbelievers. And if people come to know every beneficent quality of banafsha oil, then a very little of it will be valued as a gold coin. 6th. Advantages of chambeli, which is a tropical flower, and bakain oil. According to Imam Ali, peace be upon him, one should apply bakain oil as it has been used by the prophets. It safeguards one from all types of pains. According to Holy Prophet, there are many benefits of chambeli, that is jasmine oil. It cures 70 diseases. Even according to Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq, peace be upon him, there are many beneficial uses of chambeli oil besides its being a cure for 70 diseases. Chambeli implies white chambeli, and in Arabic the word for chambeli is razne, as stated in many traditions. 7th. Advantages of other oils. It is stated according to a tradition that the Holy Prophet said to Imam Ali, peace be upon him, that olive oil should be eaten and applied on the body because shaitan keeps away from the man who applies it for 40 days. According to a tradition, when the Holy Prophet suffered from headache, he used to put drops of washed til, that is sesame seed oil, in his nose. According to another tradition, Imam Musa Kazim, peace be upon him, used to apply oil of a flower known as gule khairon on his body. 8th. Advantages of incense, its types, and how to take it. According to Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq, peace be upon him, one should, when possible, incense one's clothes. Whoever used to enter the presence of Imam Ali Raza, peace be upon him, used to feel the aroma of incense. A tradition from Marazam states that when he once visited a bathing house with Imam Ali Raza, peace be upon him, and the Imam reached the stage of putting on clothes after the bath, he ordered for Ude Suz and applied it to his body, and then ordered that the perfume should be given to Marazam too. According to a tradition, the wife of Imam Musa Kazim, peace be upon him, used to incense her clothes by putting the seed of Subhani dates and other types of fragrant material in a fire so that the scent may increase and last longer. According to another tradition, the Holy Prophet used to smell the incense of Ude Qamari. Another tradition from the Holy Prophet states that one should take the incense of Ude Hindi as it possesses 8 kinds of cures. Another tradition quotes Imam Ali Raza, peace be upon him, as taking incense and later applying rose and musk on his body. A tradition from Sayyid ibn Taus, may Allah bless his soul, states that the Prophet used to recite the following while taking incense. All praise is for Allah, whose blessings are the cause of all goodness. O Allah, make our perfume clean and purified, and make our place of eternal rest better. Piety is our accompaniment, our place of return is heaven, and thy care and blessings are always with us. Undoubtedly, you are Almighty. 9th. Benefits of rose, rose water, and other flowers. It is stated from the Holy Prophet that washing the face with rose water enhances its beauty and removes worry and poverty. It is stated from Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq, peace be upon him, that a person who sprays a handful of rose water on his mouth on the first of Ramadan al-Mubarak will find freedom from worries, and the person who will spray a handful of water on his mouth on the eighth day will be free from cerebral disease and pneumonia. According to a tradition from Imam Ali, peace be upon him, the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and his pure progeny, gave him a handful of red flowers, and when Imam Ali, peace be upon him, started smelling them, the Prophet said that amongst the flowers of heaven, after rose, this was the best. According to another tradition, rubbing narcissus, that is Nargis, or smelling it is very advantageous. When Prophet Ibrahim, peace be upon him, was thrown in fire, and when that fire froze and he came out unburnt, God created narcissus for him, and that was how it first came on earth. 10th, etiquette of smelling flowers. According to reliable tradition from Malik Juwainir, he gave a flower to Imam Ja'far as-Sadiq, peace be upon him. He smelled it and touched his eyes with it and said that a person who smells flowers and touches his eyes with them and recites, O Allah, shower thy blessings on Muhammad and Al Muhammad, will be pardoned of his sins before he could keep it on the ground. Etiquette of sleeping, reciting duas at the time of sleeping and seeing dreams. First, timings of sleep. It should be remembered that sleeping from early hours of the morning till the rise of the sun, between Maghrib and Isha prayers, and after Namaz-e-Asr is makruh. However, sleeping is sunnat before Namaz-e-Zuhr during summer and also between Zuhr and Asr. According to another reliable tradition, if one recites extra prayers, that is Taqibat, after Namaz-e-Subh, that is morning prayers, and sleeps just before sunrise, it is not harmful. Another tradition states that Imam Ali Raza, peace be upon him, asked a man to meet him after the sun has risen completely as he slept just after his morning prayers. According to the Holy Prophet, the earth complains to God on the basis of three things. Firstly, on bloodshed without any justice. Secondly, when the water falls on the earth while taking bath after committing adultery. And thirdly, when a person is sleeping before sunrise. According to Imam Ja'far as-Sadiq, peace be upon him, sleeping during morning hours is a source of loss of income, pain, of complexion, ugliness. Sleeping at such hours is undesirable because God distributes food. One should never sleep at that time, for Bani Israel used to receive roasted chicken and trinjabeen at that time, and the sleeping one never used to receive his share. According to Holy Prophet, a person who sits on the prayer mat during those hours will be saved by God from the fire of hell. And another tradition states that person will receive the reward of Sunnat Hajj of Kaaba and his sins will be forgiven. According to Imam Muhammad al-Baqir, peace be upon him, sleeping in the early hours of morning is foolish. Sleeping in the afternoon is a blessing, and it is harmful to sleep after Asr. And sleeping between Maghrib and Isha is depriving oneself of the daily bread. Another tradition states that a person entered the presence of the Holy Prophet and said that his memory was getting worse and he is forgetting everything easily. The Holy Prophet pointed out that he has left midday nap, and the Holy Prophet bade him to do as he used to do before and his memory would improve. Second, to do ablution, that is wudu, before sleep. According to Imam Ja'far as-Sadiq, peace be upon him, when a person performs wudu before lying on a bed, his bed becomes as good as a mosque. If one forgets to perform wudu and remembers afterwards, then he can perform tayammum on the sheet with which he is covering himself. If after this form of purification and before going to bed, he thinks and praises God until he is asleep, then his sleep will be as good as prayer. According to Imam Ali, peace be upon him, a Muslim should not sleep in the state of janabat and without wudu. If water is not available for bathing or wudu, then one should perform tayammum as the spirit of the moment travels towards heaven while he is sleeping, and according to its cleanliness and purification, it is received by God. It is blessed and rewarded by God. And if he dies while sleeping, then he gets a place in the blessings of God. If he is alive, then God sends angels to guard him. According to another tradition, the Holy Prophet asked his followers that who amongst them kept fasts all year round. Hazrat Salman-e-Farsi replied that he fasted all the year round. The Holy Prophet questioned who had spent his nights in prayers, being awake all through. Again, Salman replied that he was the man in accordance with the Prophet. Then, looking at all assembled companions, the Holy Prophet asked, "Who reads one Quran every day?" All kept quiet except Salman, who replied in the affirmative. One of the assembled was furious at Salman and said to others that Salman is showing off and lying, as he had seen Salman many a days not observing fast, many a night sleeping instead of praying, and also not completing a Quran each day. The Holy Prophet intervened and said that Salman is like Luqman, and whoever doubts him should question him directly and he would reply. Then he immediately questioned Salman, and Salman gave the following answer. Every month he fasted on 13th, 14th and 15th. God has said that he will reward 10 times any good act. Therefore his 3 fasts are equal to 30 fasts, and in this manner he fasts for 1 month. It will be like keeping fasts all the year round. Besides, he fasted all through the month of Sha'ban and Ramadan. In this way he keeps more fasts when each fast will be multiplied by 10. And about being awake at night and praying, he had heard from the Holy Prophet that sleeping with wudu is equal to being awake at night and praying all the while. And about reading one complete Quran each day, he had heard from the Holy Prophet that reciting 3 Surat al-Tawheed, that is chapter 112 of the Holy Quran, is equal to reciting 1 Quran. He heard the Holy Prophet saying to Imam Ali, peace be upon him, that Ali and his followers are like Surah Tawheed in the Quran. When a person recites Surah Tawheed once, it is like reciting 1/3 of the Quran. If he recites twice, it is like reciting 2/3 of the Quran. And if he recites 3 times, it is like reciting the whole of the Quran. Then the Holy Prophet continued that a person who is just a verbal friend of Imam Ali, his face will only be 1/3 complete. The person who is literally as well as from his heart a friend of Imam Ali, then his faith is 2/3 complete. Whereas a person who is not only a literal and true friend of Imam Ali, but also practically follows him, his faith is complete. If all those on earth were as friendly towards Imam Ali, peace be upon him, as the Shias, then God would not have put any being to trial or punish them. Third, etiquettes to be observed before sleeping and the place of sleeping. According to reliable traditions, the Holy Prophet has cursed 3 types of people. A. Those who eat alone. B. Those who travel alone. And C. Those who sleep in an empty house. The probability in the last case is that man who sleeps alone will go mad on account of fear. According to Imam Ja'far as-Sadiq, peace be upon him, a person who is forced by circumstances to sleep alone in a desert or a house should recite the following prayer before going to sleep. O Allah, be my friend in depression and anxiety, and help me in my loneliness. According to another reliable tradition from Imam Ja'far as-Sadiq, peace be upon him, sleeping alone on the roof of the house is prohibited, and also on that roof which has no encircling walls. This applies both to men and women. When people asked him whether it was permissible to sleep on a roof having wall on 3 sides, he replied in the negative and said that walls should be on all the 4 sides of the roof. In certain traditions, the height of these walls was ascertained. Some stated as 2 yards and other as 1 1/4 yards. The Holy Prophet has warned that hands should not be dirty or full of food particles while going to sleep, as in that case, shaitan overcomes and it is probable that the man may get mad, and in that case, he himself is to be blamed. He also asked children's faces to be washed before they went to sleep, as otherwise shaitan will smell their hands and frighten them. Many reliable traditions state that the Holy Prophet has asked the beds to be cleaned and swept before going to bed, as any hidden harmful animal insect which is roosting inside the bed may be thrown out and the person becomes safe from any harm. Fourth, complete manners of sleeping. It is sunnat to sleep inclined on the right side and facing Qibla, and the right hand should be kept under the face. Sleeping inclined towards the left side is makruh. According to Imam Ali, peace be upon him, there are 4 ways of sleeping. When the Prophet sleep, their eyes are not closed but are waiting revelation from the Almighty God. Mu'mins or the pious sleep inclined towards right side and facing Qibla. Worldly kings and princes sleep inclined towards the left side, that the food they have eaten may be digested, and Shaitan and those who follow him sleep on their stomachs flat. In another tradition, he prohibits sleeping, lying on one's stomach, and to awake those persons who sleep in such manner, and not to let them sleep like that. He even requested the people to sleep with their right hand under the right side of their face, as one never knows whether he will ever wake up. Besides this, many other traditions have extolled the rewards or benefits of sleeping towards the right and prohibited sleeping inclining towards the left. Fifth, the verses and prayers meant to be recited before going to bed. According to a hadith from Imam Muhammad al-Baqir, peace be upon him, one has to lie in the bed with his right hand, with his right side of his face, then he should recite the following prayer. I begin in the name of Allah, O Allah, I have my life unto your care, turn my face towards you, hand over my work unto you, I am afraid only of you, and seek your good will only on you, and I depend for my salvation and towards you for refuge. I have brought faith on the book which you have sent and the apostle which you have made prophet. After this, he should recite Tasbih of Fatima al-Zahra, peace be upon her. Another tradition states that the Imam has asked the following dua to be recited with punctuality before going to bed and never to miss it. I safeguard my life, the life of my wife and children, and my property with complete wordings of Allah from every devil, harmful animal, and black eye. This prayer was recited by the Holy Prophet on Hasanain alayhi salam for their protection. According to Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq, peace be upon him, one should recite Qul ya ayyuhal kafirun and Qul huwallahu ahad before going to sleep, as the former deals with repulsion and fatigue from polytheism and the latter expresses tawheed, that is oneness of God. In the name of God, the Beneficent, the Merciful, say thou, O Apostle Muhammad, O you who disbelieve, I worship not what you worship, nor worship you whom I worship, nor shall I worship whom you worship, nor will you worship whom I worship. Unto you be your religion, and unto me my mind. In the name of God, the Beneficent, the Merciful, say, He, God, is one alone, God the needless. He begetteth not, nor is He begotten, and there is none like unto Him. Another tradition states that if a man, after being in bed, recited, All praise is for Allah, who is all elevated and almighty, and all praise is for Him only, who, though hidden himself, is well aware of everything, and all praise is for Allah, who raises up the dead and makes the living die, and He holds power over everything. Then he will be purified of his sins like a newborn baby just born of his mother. According to Imam Ali Radha, peace be upon him, a person who recites Ayatul Kursi, God, there is no God but He, the ever-living, the self-sufficient, slumber seizeth him nor not sleep. His it is whatsoever is in the heavens and whatsoever is on the earth. Who is he that can intercede with him but with his permission? He knoweth what is before them and what is behind them, while they cannot comprehend anything out of his knowledge save that which he willeth. His throne extendeth over the heavens and the earth, and the preservation of them both tireth him not, and he is the most high and most great. No compulsion be in religion. Indeed, truth has been made manifest, distinct from error. Therefore, he who disbelieveth the rebels, false deities, and believeth in God has indeed laid hold on the strongest handle. No break is for it. And verily, God is all-hearing, all-knowing. Allah is the guardian of those who believe. He taketh them but of darkness into light. And those who disbelieve, the rebels in their gardens, they take out from light to darkness. They are the companions of the hellfire, therein they shall abide. Before going to bed, will be safe from paralysis. According to Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq, peace be upon him, if a person recites Surah Yasin before going to bed, God will send 1,000 angels to guard him from the mischief of Shaitan or any other harm. According to Imam Muhammad al-Baqir, peace be upon him, a person who recites Surah Waqiyah, chapter 56, every night before he goes to bed, will have a face shining like the moon of the 14th night on the day of judgment. According to another tradition from him, no scorpion or insect will bite the person who will recite the following dua at night. I seek shelter from that sting which has been evil and from the mischief of all those things which walk over the earth, and Allah only is aware of their destiny. I seek shelter through the words, that is the kalima of Allah, whose power no good or bad thing can escape. There is no doubt that my Allah is the right path. Undoubtedly, Allah has restrained the heaven and the earth from deterioration, and if they deteriorate, is there anyone who can check them? Undoubtedly, Allah is Almighty and Forgiver. According to Imam Ja'far as-Sadiq, peace be upon him, a person who recites, "There is no God but one Allah," 10 times while going to sleep will have a house in heaven for him made by God. And a person who recites 100 times will be washed off all his sins as the leaves fall down from a tree. According to another reliable tradition from Imam Ja'far as-Sadiq, peace be upon him, a person who recites Surah Qul Huwallahu Ahad, that is Surah Tawheed, 7 times before going to bed will have all his sins forgiven and his neighbors will be safe from any harm. And if he recites this surah 100 times, then all the sins which he may commit during the next 50 years in nature will be forgiven. Another tradition from the Imam states that if a person recites the following dua before going to bed, O Allah, I hold you witness unto me that you have made the love of Hazrat Ali ibn Abi Talib, Hasan and Husayn ibn Ali, Ali ibn al-Husayn, Muhammad ibn Ali, Ja'far bin Muhammad, Musa ibn Ja'far, Ali bin Musa, Muhammad bin Ali, Ali bin Muhammad, Hasan bin Ali and Hujjat Qa'im incumbent on me, and dies during the night, then he will enter heaven. According to a reliable tradition from Imam Ali ibn al-Husayn, peace be upon him, a person who recites the following prayer while going to bed will be freed from poverty and worry and will be safe from the insects and animals who bite. O Allah, you are the first before whom nothing even existed, and you are the Almighty and well-revered, and nothing is greater than you, and you are hidden, though there is nothing that is not known to you, and you are such a last after which nothing will exist. O Allah, who cherishes me Tawrat, Injil and Zabur and the wisdom of the Quran, keep me safe from the mischief of all those things which crawl on the earth, the destiny of which you alone know. I seek refuge with you only, who undoubtedly is the right path.